Vandeham Sri Guru.
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 2nd Canto, 3rd Chapter, text number 1 through 3, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 22nd of May, 1972, in Los Angeles, California.
Sri Rupam Chakrajatam Sahagana Raghunathantam Swam Sajivam. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunya Bihari.
Jaya Radha Madhava Kunya Bihari.
Jaya Radha Madhava Kunya Bihari. Vallabha Giri Varadhari
Gopi Gana Vallabha Giri Varadhari
Gopi Gana Vallabha Giri Varadhari
Gopi Gana
Vallabha Giri Varadhari
Gopi Gana Vallabha.
परिज्ञान कथा जो सुतर सरस्वाद भक्तिदान सरस्वती गोस्वामी तो बात की जय अनंत पुरी वैष्णविंद की जय रामाचार्य श्री हरिदास ठाकुर की जय प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत कदाधान सुभाष आदि गौर भक्तिविंद की जय श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड जी गोवर्धन की जय वृंदावन धाम की जय नवद्वीप धाम की जय गंगा माई की जय यमुना माई की जय तुलसी देवी की जय भक्ति देवी की जय स्वामी तो भक्तविंद की जय ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असमल ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असमल ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असमल थैंक यू वेरी मच
Love cannot be possible. This very word, love, pray, especially deserve all Krishna. Prema Kumartha Maha, that is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu preaching. The highest perfection of life is to evoke one's dormant love for Krishna. The love is there, it is reserved for Krishna. But due to our foolishness, we are distributing that love in so many ways to the dog. This is Kali Yuga. We do not know where to apply love. And you see, all these words is touched with the word karma. Karma. Karma means love. There is no question of love. Then love, prema and karma is described in Chaitanya Chaitanya. What is prema and karma? Atmendriya priti vancha karanam karma. Karma. What is love? Atmendriya priti. To satisfy one's own senses. That is karma. Here, a boy and girl love. They say love, but no, it is not love. The boy wants to satisfy his senses and the girl wants to satisfy her senses. Therefore, Atmendriya Priti Pancha. Everyone is trying to satisfy her own senses. That is karma. Lust. And then what is prema? Krishnandriya Priti Vancha Dhare Prema. When the same propensity is transferred for satisfying Krishna's sense, just like gopis, the super essence of gopis is due that they wanted to satisfy Krishna. They dressed very nicely because they thought that Krishna becomes very pleased seeing us nicely dressed. Not that in this material world a woman or a girl dress a very nice thing just to attract the opposite sex for a second. That's all. So everyone, all this description is given here. Brahma Vartasa Kama, Bija Kama, then Vasu Kama, Devi Mayantu Sri Kama, Sri. Sri means duty. And the Durga Puja, Devi Puja. They ask, after offering Mother Durga, all sorts of paraphernalia. Then the Pushpanjali, they pray, favor, Dhanam Dehi, Upam Dehi, Balam Dehi, Dehi. They meet him. After, therefore it is called Puja. Puja, that's like in business circle, if you want to take some business from a big merchant, so you satisfy him, flatter him, and sometimes invite him in a hotel and give him nice dinner in this way. After he is satisfied, you will kindly give me this contract. Or you will give me this post. The ultimate thing is, he is post and contract, not to satisfy the person. No. He is spending some money for his own sentence. Similarly, all these pujas, the demigod puja, that is for his Sanskrit puja. Krishna therefore condemns this. Kamaskrita hitav jnana jajanti janna devata. This very kama. These words, kama, 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 kama. So Krishna also says, so you won't find any difference between Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, or any way it is. It is to be understood through proper charity. So all these kamas have been condemned by Krishna. Kamastasthayitabhyanam jajandiyannadiyota. They persons who go to worship other demigods, like Devi, Maya, Durga, Shiva, or Indra, Chandra, so many, there are 33 crore. 1 crore is equal to
10 million.
And 33. Just see, there are so many demigods and so many desires also. So they are not private. Everything is there in the Bhagavad Gita. If you want this particular, Sankhantam Karmanam Siddhi Jajante Yodhivata, that is stated in Bhagavad Gita. Those who want quick success in fulfilling some material desires, they worship the demigods. The Mayavadi, Sankarais, they have many helpers. They have made so much blunder in understanding the Vedic confusion. Misleading, simply. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has specially warned that anyone who hears about the Mayavad commentation, he is doomed, he is gone forever, lost. He will have no understanding either this way or that. The Vedas, they give us information of the demigod, but they are not imagination. Neither Krishna is imagination. The Mahabharata says everything is imagination. The Bhagavata is giving this direction, Bhagavata means Vedas, is giving direction that if we want this prophet, then worship this demigod. He is playing childish, foolish things. He is giving some wrong information, imagination. What business he has got to do that? But this Mayavadika sense will say that the demigods are also Maya, that Krishna is all Maya, everything is Maya. That we call them Mayavad. Everything is Maya. Krishna Bhakti is Maya. They say it is good for raising oneself to the platform of impersonalism. There are processes that you, if you want to go higher platform, you take one staircase and get on it and then throw it. Because you don't require to come down it. That is the pillar. So you take any means. Ramakrishna Mission also said like that. Jatamata. You can worship Brahma Vaksha, you can worship Devi Maya, you can worship Vasu, you can worship Rudra, you can worship anyone. Ultimately, you become one to the Supreme. Most things misguided. Here it is, but if you want this particular thing, then you worship this. In the Bhagavad Gita also it is confirmed, Janti Deva Pratar Devam, the three Janti Deva Pratar. Demigod worshippers will go to the demigod. There are different planets, 33 crores or demigods, and there are 33 crores of planets also. The moon planet, according to Vedic literature, that is also one of the planets belonging to the demigod Chandra. It is one of the higher planets. So, this is the least. If you want something particular, if you want to merge into the Upajan, Brahma Jyoti, then you worship Jajita Brahmana Patim. Brahmana, Brahmana, Brahma means also Veda, Sabda Brahma. Tini Brahma Rida, in the Bhagavad beginning. Brahma means the sound, transcendental sound of knowledge. That is, Veda. So, there is Upanishad. So, Upanishad, the generally, those who are scholars in Upanishad, they want to become one with the. So that is not really very difficult thing. Anyone can do that. There is a process. But we Vaishnava, we do not accept that suicidal words. We want to keep our individuality, not merge. We don't want to finish our identity. Our real identity is eternal servant of Krishna. Jive Sarupa Nitya Krishna Das. So we want to keep that identity and we want to serve him eternally. Eternally means now we are in this material world. We are being trained now how to serve Krishna. This deity was saying, this is training. The same thing we continue and we go to Vaikuntha Vrindavan. The same way we serve personally. So here Krishna, this is also personal. But due to my imperfectness, I cannot see Krishna in his actual spiritual form, Satchidananda Vigraha. Therefore, Krishna has assumed a form which you can approach. It is for your facility. And Krishna, in any form he appears, he is transcendental. Either this form or that. Rama Chintamani Krishna, Chaitanya Rasudhi, everything. That is Krishna's speciality. He can appear just like if you have got a photograph of some of your friends. So you cannot derive the benefit of direct image. But in Krishna's form, if you have a Krishna's photograph, it is as good as Krishna. You can get the same benefit from the photograph picture of Krishna as you get benefit by directly meeting him. Therefore, meeting this photograph, busy of Krishna, is as good as Krishna. Advayam, non-dwelling. Here in this material there is dwelling, but in the spiritual world there is no such dwelling. Brahma-varchas kāmastu jadeta brahmanapati indram. Indra kamas, Indra being senses. Those who are too much lusty, satisfied, simply. The most important Indra is the genital sex. So for them it is recommended that he worship Indra. Indra, the demigod, is number one sexually inclined demigod. He has got eyes for all his body. Sattachakya. These eyes were originally Vajrayana. He was touched by Gautam Muni that you are so fond of Vajrayana. I touch you that you get all over your body Vajrayana. Then when he surrendered, he began to cry that it will be very much abominable for me. Then he offered that this vagina may be turned into eyes. Therefore, his body is full of eyes. So those who are too much nasty, lover of the vagina, they may worship Indra. This is the Vedanta. Everything is there. If you want vagina instead of Krishna, all right, beautiful. Well, so unfortunately, if our student falls a victim of Vajrayana instead of Krishna, that is very regrettable. Then better he worship instead of Krishna, let him worship Indra. That is the Bhagavad Gita. Indram Indra kamastu praja kamas prajapatim. Praja, many things there. That is, just like aristocratic life, one is working very hard to establish a family. In England, it is very prominent. Lord family, Duke family. And where the husband is going himself, he does not know. But establishing a family, Lord family. Praja, people want their son, grandson, great-grandson, his son, family will be filled up with so many, in India especially, the Kornis, they want like that. Sri Sancha Pradevsa, Sri Beauty, beautiful woman, Sri Oisanja, well, and Praja. Praja means many things. They are spending their whole time earning money, amass money, huge bank balance. Then his sons are married, the same thing, he begotten so many children by self. So he is giving indulgence to his sons, all like you also take the sex indulgence and produce many children. Pradipsa. And then grandchildren, or also you also take another, you also produce children. They are called Pradipsa. They want, they are happy to see that he has got many children, just like Dhritarashtra. He had 100 sons. And the 100 sons are another 100 sons. So he was after how this kingdom should be in my son's hands. So that is the cause of Kurukshetra war. So Pradesha, Prajana. So there are so many karmas, desires. Different people, different karmas. So, they are all hitogyana. Anyone who is impeded by this karma, they are legends. Karma is just the hitogyana. Hitogyana means one who has lost intelligence. They are captivated by these kinds of lusty things. Janamaituna didhya meri sukham nitucham. Prajaskama. Those who want children, get can children. In Bengali there is a proverb. Nati nati shavdeva. Nati means grandson. And grandson's grandson. That when I am living, my son is living, my grandson is living, his son is living, his son is living. In this way, up to 7th generation, if one sees, then immediately goes to them. These are the conception of the materialistic person. That if I can see a grandson of a grandson, then my life is and is working hard for this purpose. They are called Prajanama. Praja means many sons to be family. That is sons which are very aristocratic. Prajanama Prajapatim Devim Mayam to Sri Kamas. Sri means beauty. If you want to become very beautiful, either man or woman, then worship Durga. Srishti Sthiti Prada Sarasa. Tejas kama vibhavasam, vibhavasam. There are bhasur, 8 kinds of bhasur. So you can worship one of the bhasur if you want to be very influential person, like Mr. Nixon. Then you worship vibhavasam. Bhasu kama, bhasu natu dhyan, bhasu means where? If you want, well, riches. So, least is there, but Krishna says this will not make you happy, my dear friend. Sarvadharma paritraja mame gosvami. You will kill up all this nonsense. Is that an end? That is Krishna just says. Sarvadharma paritraja mame gosvami. Because he is the supreme, he is giving supreme advice. But there are other persons to regulate them. Because these are called yajnas, saho yajnas yajnasya, where he is little touch of devotion, indirect. Because if you want to worship Indra, you must worship at the same time Narayan, that is the system. Narayan Sila is there. Because the benediction you want from the particular type of Vedika, he cannot give independence. Why? He takes permission from Narayana. So he is after this benediction from me and he is worshipping me. So shall I give him this benediction? So with this order, because after Ishavasvinam Sadmam, everything is Krishna's property. How? Suppose somebody is cashier in our institution. He is getting a thousands of dollars any cutlery. He cannot distribute without being thanked. That's not good. So he must thank the superior sanction. That's what I give him. Similarly, all these demigods, they cannot give you anything directly with the permission of the Supreme Personality of God. For invoke hitan hitan, they have benefit which they derive from the demigod, that is ordained by Krishna, Krishna said. When the demigod appeals to Krishna that this person is hankering after this thing and is worshipping me, so just to keep the position of the demigod, Krishna said, all right, give it. Because the demigods are servants of Krishna, so one has approached the servant of Krishna to keep the position of the servant of Krishna orders, yes, we give. Then like Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu took benediction from Brahma. So I shall not die at this time, I shall not die night, I shall not die on land, I shall not die on water. These were all definition by the Gita. Brahma said, yes. Now to keep the words of Brahma, Krishna is so kind, with Brahma his servant. He appeared in such a way that all the prayers of Hiranyakashipu was not touched. Hiranyakashipu said that I shall not die by any man or any animal or any demigod. So he appeared in Nishinga Mukti, who is neither animal nor man nor demigod. You cannot define. Then Hiranyakashipu prayed for that I shall not die in daytime, at night, yes. So Hiranyakashipu was killed in the sunlight, within the junction of day and night. Just in the evening. You cannot say it is day, neither is night. In this way, Krishna kept all the words of Brahma and still did. That is true. That is true. Then you may be very intelligent to avoid Krishna or the laws of Krishna, but Krishna is more intelligent. He will also cheat you because he wanted to cheat him. So he will also cheat you in such a way that you will be beyond your imagination. That is Krishna. You cannot excel Krishna. You have to be always under him, even your cheating process. This is Krishna. So take shelter of Krishna and be happy.